test.
Hello. Can you go check for this one? Because I can't hear this one. Can you hear this one? I think I can hear both of them. I can hear this one. I can hear this one. They're both working.
try everything you can. And don't you worry what they tell themselves when you're away. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in a little out the ride. Everything, everything will be just fine. Everything, everything will be alright, alright. Hey, you know they're all the same. You know you're doing better on your own. So don't buy in. Live right now. Yeah, just be yourself. It doesn't matter if it's good enough for someone else. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in a little out the ride. Everything, everything will be just fine. Everything, everything will be alright, alright. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in a little out the ride. Everything, everything will be just fine. Everything, everything will be alright, alright. Don't write yourself off yet. It's only in your head you feel left out. Look down on. Just do your best. Teach everything you can. And don't you worry what their bitter hearts are gonna say. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in a little out the ride. Everything, everything will be just fine.
Black and white. Try to keep an open mind, but I just can't sleep on this tonight. Stop this train. I wanna get off and go home again. I can't take the speed it's moving in. I know I can't, but honestly, won't someone stop this train? Has just begun. Had a talk with my old man. Said, help me understand. He said, turn 68. You renegotiate. Don't stop this train. Don't for a minute change the place you're in. And don't think I couldn't ever understand. I tried. Once in a while,
Good evening, everyone. Is this thing on? Can you all hear me fine? Good. All right, thank you. Good evening, everyone. It is my pleasure to welcome you to Clayton A. Bouton's commencement ceremony. I ask you all kindly take your seats, which you have before I even started speaking, and enjoy the senior video as we prepare for the ceremony.
Come. out in Hackensack. Is that all you get for your money? And it seems such a waste of time. If that's what it's all about, mama, if that's moving up, then I'm moving out. Out.
Teachers and friends.
Yes, all the friends.
I feel pretty splendid.
Crazy, sentimental.
I will miss the school.
I'm so excited. I feel good.
Feel good?
Yeah.
Dude, I'm excited. I'm a little nervous, but you know, I got a lot of stuff to look forward to.
I'm so excited to start this next chapter of my life. I'm so sad to not be with my good friends anymore.
You know, it's been a long run.
I feel really sad. I'm gonna miss you guys.
I'm sad to see the seniors go, but I'm really happy that they're gonna be able to go on whatever journeys they're looking to go on. And I'm very glad that I do get a chance to hang out with them tomorrow for the senior trip and get to see them walk across the stage on the 24th. So a little bit of mixed emotions today, so.
Good evening. My name is Gabby Rychek.
And my name is Emma Farrell.
And tonight, it is our pleasure to welcome family, friends, faculty, and staff to the Class of 2022 graduation commencement ceremony.
We would like to especially thank Mr. McCree, Mr. Shea, Mr. Sapienza, teachers, and the Board of Education for allowing us to achieve all of our goals throughout high school. Lastly, we would like to give thanks to family and friends for always supporting and never giving up on us. Congrats, Class of 2022.
Now, can everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, done by Aiden Strauss, and please remain standing for the National Anthem, performed by Devani Gibson and Samantha Olson.
I pledge allegiance to the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free and the home of the
friends, family, faculty, and the class of 2022. When I think of my high school years, I think of the most cliche graduation speech quote ever. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times. As we reminisce on all our favorite memories we had here at Voorheesville, like field day, the fifth grade play, middle school field trips, the winter wave, and Sweethearts and Heroes, where the pink mark that Jack Barringer left 6 years ago can still be seen way up there, we also remember the tough times we've had, like when we learned what the score discussion was in ninth grade global, the swimming unit in gym class, the stress of character day, and of course, the pandemic. But let's not focus on the negatives of high school, because that's in the past. We pushed through, we persevered. We learned things that will help make our futures great, like what happened in the 1600s, what year Shakespeare was born and died, 1564 to 1660, in case you forgot. And most importantly, that the mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell. Well, some of the things we learned, we may never use again. We did learn many things that will help us immensely in our futures. We learned that there is nothing we can't do if we put our minds to it. We learned to overcome our fears. In sixth grade, I came out right here to the front of this stage to audition for the show Annie. I was shaking, sweating, fumbling over my words. I messed up, claimed I had a voice crack, and asked to start over. You guessed it, I was a proud member of the ensemble. If you had told me then that I would be up on stage right now speaking to you all, I never would have believed you. As I've spent a lot of time in this auditorium working on the lights, I've attended almost every graduation since I was in seventh grade. I always thought it was so cool that kids could come up here, speak to a crowd of this size, and not even look a little nervous. Right then, back in seventh grade, I promised myself that I would be here one day, giving a speech at my graduation. Flash forward to today, I've played music in front of crowds more times than I can count. I recently played Linus in the high school show, and I'm standing here today, fulfilling 13-year-old Connor's dream. My fear of public speaking was something that I overcame during my time at Voorheesville. We learned how to work together, how to face a challenge and persevere through it. But most importantly, we learned about ourselves. And no, not in that way, Mr. Cairns, this is not health class. No, we learned to be true to ourselves, how to pave our own path, our interests and goals, how to respect others and ourselves. Now, we all start somewhere, and that somewhere is usually the first thing that's written on your Wikipedia page when you get famous. Let's pretend I'm some rando reading a Wikipedia page about Connor Smith, say, 20 years from now. Go something like, Connor Smith grew up in Voorheesville, New York, before he became a famous... That's the thing. We don't know what we'll become famous for. We don't know if we'll have our own Wikipedia page in the future. We don't even know if Wikipedia will exist in the future. But we do know that we have the opportunity. See, most people look at fame as how many followers you have on Instagram, how many likes you get on TikTok, or how many times Miss Guido has caught you wandering the halls without a pass over the years. What we should do is look at fame as the real impact you leave on people and what your legacy is. Take a moment to think about your legacy, the legacy you left here at Clayton A. Bouton, the legacy you hope to leave in the future. While some of us will return to our hometown, others may find a new place to call home. Our hometown, a little village with three pizza places, a grocery store, and not much else. Yet, Voorheesville left us with some memories that will last a lifetime, like freeze pops after Qantas games, and some of the best Memorial Day fireworks around. As I look around, I can think of a memory I have with each of you, no matter how small of a moment it was. As you watch your peers walk up and receive their diplomas later tonight, I almost guarantee that you know everyone's names, something about them, and have some sort of memory with them. That's something really special that our small town has given us over the years. Voorheesville's brought us together, brought us closer, created a comforting hometown, one that we'll always be welcomed back to. Now, you may be thinking, what's this kid? National Honor Society co-president, cross-country captain, lighting genius, musician, ghost stream not meant to be on all streaming platforms, know about giving advice on the future? Well, the answer is that I don't. I'm in the same boat as all of you. Later tonight, I too will walk across this stage, receive my diploma, and begin a new chapter in my life. But I'm optimistic. Optimistic about making my future great. And you all should be too. See, we don't know what the future holds, but that's okay. It's up to us to make our futures our own, live our best lives, and make our dreams come true. I know many of you, like myself, are excited to get out there. Start fresh, explore the world, leave your legacy. But I encourage you to remember where you started, because we all start somewhere. And in my opinion, Voorheesville was a great place to start. I wish each and every one of you nothing but the best. Thank you, and huge congratulations to the class 2022.
Hi, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Charlie Beauregard. I came to Voorheesville in the second grade, and for the first few months, I had no friends because, you know, making friends is hard. One day, I was coloring something in for a school assignment, as one does when they're 7 years old, when the person sitting across from me started picking on me. This was so long ago that I honestly don't remember who it was or what they were saying, but I do remember that the girl next to me told them to leave me alone and mind their own business. This may sound like nothing now, but back then it was something I never thought would happen. So naturally, I asked that girl if she'd be my friend. Nearly 11 years later, I am still pinching myself that she said yes. Victoria is one of my closest friends and my oldest friend here at Voorheesville, and I can think of no one with greater integrity or strength of character as her. After all, who else could pull off those amazing cat ears for so many wonderful years through middle and early high school? I am so pleased to introduce her as Voorheesville's graduating class of 2022's salutatorian, my close friend, Victoria Iacobucci.
Thank you, Charlie, and good evening to everyone here tonight, as well as those joining us on the live stream. It is my pleasure to welcome you again to the graduation ceremony of the class of 2022. The past 4 years have been filled with ups and downs, and it's hard to believe we're finally here. A few weeks ago, we all got on a bus and went to the elementary school, where we walked through the entire school in our caps and gowns. And as I'm sure my friends can confirm, I said something along the lines of, "I think the building got smaller." Of course, I was informed that the building did not, in fact, get smaller, but that I got bigger. And I knew that, but I didn't want to believe it, since this was my first experience that really showed me just how far we've come as a class. Some days, it feels like it was only yesterday that we had to come to school for just half the day as kindergartners, or that we couldn't wait for the last 26 days of school, not because it was almost over, but so we could do the ABC countdown. And who could forget the time we surprised the lower grade levels by doing body percussion to the alma mater on the balconies of the large gym? All of our elementary school memories led to the moment where half of us cried while singing "For Good" from Wicked during our fifth grade graduation. And it may seem dramatic, since all we did was move 5 minutes down the road, but it's no different than how we feel right now. When we look back on our fondest memories of our time at Voorheesville, we see the moments that have shaped us into the people we are today. The friends you played with on the playground in elementary school may not be the friends you sat with at lunch this year. And your favorite subject then may not be your favorite now. These changes may seem small to the people around us, but they show how we've grown over the years. And when you look at it that way, suddenly our tears at the end of fifth grade make a little more sense, as we really have changed for good. Some of us may not have the best memories from our time here. And to you, I say you don't have to focus on how far you've come, but rather how far you'll go. Each and every person in this class has a promising future ahead of them. Whether you're going to a university, trade school, enlisting in the military, or going straight to the workforce, the experience we've had here at Voorheesville High School will accompany us and will guide us towards becoming the best version of ourselves we could ever dream to be. What's important to note is that this Voorheesville experience wouldn't be possible without the people here today. So I'd like to thank everyone for their support and contributions to this class and this outstanding school. To the administration, thank you for being Voorheesville's foundation and always seeking out ways to improve the quality of the school and the student experience. Though much of what you do is behind the scenes, it does not go unappreciated. To the teachers, thank you for dedicating so much of your time to providing us the best education around, and for accepting our late work despite being told as eighth graders that it wouldn't fly in high school. And to family, friends, and everyone in the audience tonight, thank you for your endless support in every moment leading up to this day. Despite all that has been thrown at us in the past few years as a community, you have stood by us through it all, and who knows where we'd be without you. Now, I know all of you, as well as myself, are eager to receive our diploma and walk off the stage as a high school graduate. So I will keep this short and end by saying that I am honored to be the class of 2022 salutatorian, and I'm so incredibly proud of this class and all they've accomplished. Thank you.
Hi all, thank you for being here today to celebrate our special day. My name is Abby Sidoti, and one of the many things I got to be a part of during my time at Voorheesville was being a class officer. Class officers hold many responsibilities like fundraising, planning trips, and planning prom. Our class decided that the best use of the rest of our money would be to give it to the class of 2023, the incoming seniors. We hope they have just a fun senior year as all of us did and wish them the best because it does fly by. Thank you.
Hi, it's me again. Surprising, I know. This year, I had the pleasure of being asked to introduce not only one of my closest friends, but also my twin sister. A few years ago, a different set of twins were standing here for their own graduation. I don't know if you remember, but my sister and I were working tech for that show, for that year. My sister and I watched from our places at the light and sound booths, respectfully, and afterwards, she told me that if she was valedictorian, she wanted me to introduce her, just like they did. I didn't have to think twice before saying yes, because I knew if anyone could get there, she would. She is by far the most hardworking and studious individual I've ever known, even going so far as to study at the Thanksgiving table. She is an example to us all, and all you have to do is talk to her to see why. My sister inspires greatness. She inspires me, her friends, anyone and everyone around her. She is truly an exceptional human being. Lena, I am so proud of you, and I am so proud to be your brother. It gives me no greater pleasure to introduce the Voorheesville class of 2022's valedictorian, my sister, Lelena Beauregard.
Thank you so much, Charlie. Actually, a little bit teary, so. Thank you, everyone, for coming to the graduation ceremony of the class of 2022. As all of us are sitting here, finally moments away from getting handed our diplomas, probably a mix of sad and happy emotions, I can't help but look back at the past years and see how much we've changed. Our class was the first class ever to have a third grade show, Mice from Outer Space. I still remember how each of us looked in our felt headband ears and our red space mice sashes as we were crowded on the elementary school risers. The next year, as we danced in New York State Day, we became at least a little bit taller. And as we have gotten older and eventually joined the middle school, we started to focus maybe a little less on ourselves and a little more on others. We've gotten closer with the teachers, and I know we'll be equally sad to leave them as we will be to leave our peers. Looking back, not only is the enthusiasm of Miss Abba and her chorus, or Miss Levy's long red ink paragraphs, which decorated each of our essays, very memorable, but it has shown us just how important it is to do something we are truly passionate about. On behalf of the class, I wanted to say thank you to every single teacher, administrator, past and present, or a person in our lives who has helped show us the importance of passion. And whether or not any of us will miss Ms. Doyle's "it's just math," Mr. Lawrence's endless sarcasm, Mr. Stumbau's odd fear of sharks, or the way Mr. Simon says "m'lady" every time he hands some of us our papers, it's little things like these that we remember and take with us into our coming adventures. After debating it in my head for many weeks about what message this really should be about, I finally settled on something which has grown into a little life motto for me. It all started during the last days of the high school musical. The Friday show had gone extremely well, but the Saturday show did not run quite as smoothly. After the LGI was mostly deserted, my only companion being some extra water bottles and the bins of makeup for the next day, Paige, the stage manager, showed up beside me, exhausted and sad about what had happened. Although the Saturday run was filled with a lot of what I like to call damn it moments, as many people know, to the point where I didn't even make it on stage for bows, don't worry, no one was hurt, there really was nowhere at that point to go but up. So that's what I told her, just in a shorter, condensed version. I said, think parabola. You might be wondering, how could math possibly give life advice? Well, I can tell you. Life isn't always a straight line. It's rather curvy. There are highs and lows, relative maxes and mins, if you want to get math about it, mathy. There are surprises, changes in plans, goodbyes, and even pandemics, whether you want them or not. However, one thing they all have in common is that these minimums don't last forever. They are there just for you to overcome them. And maybe for some of you, high school was a low. But to you, I say that valleys are only valleys because they eventually become mountains. The lows will rise, and you will rise above them too. And although it can be more than challenging to even believe that it can get better, just look at our class. I don't know how to describe our class other than this. We are the class of perseverance. We've survived a year and a half of COVID, distance learning, and somehow here we are on the other side, relatively unscathed. I think this is living proof. The curve truly always comes back up. And yes, I know Mr. Simons will go ahead and say, what if the parabola is negative? Or what if you use a plus or minus square root graph? But him, I'm just gonna say, shush. It's the idea that counts. I know in the next phase of our lives, it will be filled with both highs and lows. But my message to you is not to let those lows keep you down for too long, because life is too short to let it. Rachel once said to me, the goal is always to break the curriculum with our ambition. So go out and show the world just how talented, smart, driven, and ambitious you really are. Be passionate about what you do, and think parabola. Thank you.
Good evening. The principal of a school should be a leader. It is their job to commit to high standards, both academically and in the safety of the school environment. They should strive to develop strong leadership skills among their students while improving the quality of both teaching and learning. It is not an easy job, but when Voorheesville needed someone, Mr. Shea was the right person for the job. Mr. Shea is originally from Fond du Foltonville, a small town like ours. He received his bachelor's in social studies and education from SUNY Oswego, and later received his master's in adolescent special education from the College of St. Rose. He's previously worked in districts such as Cairo-Durham, Brookshire, and even helped open a school down in Hudson. Before taking on his job here, he served as an assistant academy principal and later the academy principal of the Discovery Academy at Albany High School. Each school has different needs, and one of Mr. Shea's most important jobs this year was to learn ours. Before our senior year started, the class officers wanted to meet in order to begin our annual planning. When I arrived, Mr. Shea was there, ready to hear our ideas and our concerns going into the fall, and he didn't stop there. At almost any sectional game, school concert, banquet, prom, among other events, he was there. By involving himself in the community, Mr. Shea has begun to learn what our school needs and shaped a vision for what Voorheesville should be moving forward. The seniors would like to thank him for finishing our journey with us. We hope we are a great first chapter to your story as a Blackbird. I now introduce Mr. Richard Shea.
Thank you, Daniel, for that introduction. Good evening. As Daniel mentioned, my name is Rick Shea, and I am the principal here at Clayton A. Bouton High School. It is my pleasure to welcome all of you, parents, other family members, friends, teachers, the Board of Education, superintendent, guest speaker, and most of all, our soon-to-be graduates. Tonight is an event that invokes different feelings and emotions for graduates, excitement and anticipation of the beginning of a new chapter in life, sadness as you leave a place that has nurtured some of you for 13 years, four of which you spent here at Clayton A. Bouton, trepidation in contemplating what lies ahead, joys and satisfaction for what has been achieved over the roller coaster of the last 4 years. But you are minutes away from graduating. You made it. While thinking of what I wanted to say here tonight, I found myself listening to the newest Weezer song. Yeah, some of you know me too much to realize I might have been saying a Dave Matthews song. No one here knows, but I am horrible at song lyrics, notorious actually, for making up lyrics that I am positive goes with the song, until I look them up and realize I've been completely wrong. Either way, I'm singing along. A little bit of luck goes a pretty long way. Take a look at where you started from and where you are today. You've climbed mountains, swam oceans, you've got knocked down and kept going. In the end, you know you gotta say, a little bit of luck goes a pretty long way. As I listened and had my own little car karaoke session on the way home, I started to reflect. Getting here to graduation or through any graduation night or through any challenging time in your life, and there will be challenges, it doesn't take luck. Getting here, getting through those challenging times, going through those mountains, mountain highs and valley lows, it takes grit, determination, courage, sacrifice, endurance, and the list goes on. There is nothing lucky about any of you being here tonight. You've earned this. Seize this moment. To get here tonight, you've already gone through 13 years of formal education. That's roughly 2,340 days, or 16,380 hours. You've spent even more time studying for those dreaded AP exams and Regents exams. Then there's the sports, community service, clubs, performing arts, and other extracurricular activities that you all participate in. And then there's that pandemic that threw everyone for a curveball the last 2.5 years. Through it all, you've maintained your grit and determination to achieve your graduation here tonight. This has provided all of you with opportunities that are just amazing. Many of you plan on going to college or trade school. We have graduates traveling to colleges in Florida, Michigan, Colorado, California, and other far-off states, along with several SUNY and other colleges and universities here in New York State. Programs of study that include engineering, forensics, civil engineering, education, business, sports management, medicine, psychology, programming, music, science, graphic design, pre-law, and that list goes on. Some of you plan on going to the workforce, several with a career and technical education certificate. This CTE certificate puts you at the forefront of the workforce in areas such as heavy machinery, welding, aviation, among others. We also have seniors doing a semester at sea, a church mission, junior hockey in Boston, taking a gap year, and heading back to their home countries after sharing a year with us here at Voorheesville. Your graduates are going off to do amazing things from the four walls here. Now back to my karaoke moment and singing to the song, A Little Bit of Luck. After a few more karaoke sessions, I finally decided to look up the lyrics because I was bothered by the fact that Weezer would say, sing a song about luck with lyrics that aren't I feel about luck at all. Then lo and behold, I look up the lyrics and realize I've been completely wrong. It's a little bit of love. Told you, horrible with song lyrics. So before I depart, and you depart in your individual journeys, I'd like to share a little bit of love with you and to share some of what I call Shay's Pearls of Wisdom. Don't be afraid to ask for help. Call your mother, father, guardian, whomever. They think about you more than you'll know when you're gone. Then they'll appreciate that phone call. Don't just text. Find a mentor. To this day, I think about the adults that have mentored me to be the person I am today. Find someone that you admire and can look up to as an example. Love your job. There's an advice in our world that sounds like, do the work you love. And I don't agree. You should pursue your dreams. But that doesn't mean your current job, even if it's not the greatest passion in the world, can't be enjoyed. appreciated, and loved. There is no perfect jobs in the world, so look for reasons to love the one you've got. Look up more. The person in front of you is more important than your phone. Look up and at them. Think of others. Don't live looking out for only your own interest. Look out for others' interest as well. Try new things. Try new hobbies. Try new foods. Learn a new skill. Experience new cultures. You never know for sure what's going to be you're going to be best at, so keep trying new things. And last but not least, smile and be kind. In a world where you can be anything, be kind, and a smile goes a long way too. Soon-to-be graduates, I hope you take just one of these pearls and a little bit of love with you as you embark on your own unique journeys that will start here tonight. Congratulations again, and I am thrilled to have the opportunity to be your principal during your senior year. Best of luck, and keep us posted on your future endeavors. You are all ready to do great things.
Good evening, family, friends, and soon-to-be graduates of Voorheesville High School. My name is Rachel Paul, and tonight I have the honor of introducing Mr. Frank McCree, our superintendent of schools here at Voorheesville. Mr. McCree has been an active part of our community for 17 years. Although he began his tenure as superintendent in 2020, amidst the stress and confusion of the coronavirus pandemic, he has already made a lasting impact on the district with his positive and progressive attitude. Mr. McCree is dedicated to Voorheesville and the success of its students. He demonstrates this by his constant commitment to excellence and his true kindness and compassion towards everyone in this school community. By facing the challenges that have arisen in these past 3 years, Mr. McCree has truly set an example for leadership and service, and I know he will continue to improve VCSD long into the future. I am happy to introduce the superintendent of schools, Mr. Frank McCree.
Thank you, Rachel. On behalf of the Board of Education, school administration, faculty, and staff, I welcome you, the staff, parents, family, and friends, to this momentous event in the celebrates of our guests of honor, the class of 2022. You guys are up on display. This is your night. This is my 17th graduation commencement ceremony and my 13th graduation speech as an administrator. Each year, I try to convey messages that I feel would best meet the needs of the students. Most years, I already have a theme or concept laid out by January, but I'm gonna be really honest with you. I had no idea what this speech was gonna be until the night of the high school concert, roughly a month ago. So I want you to picture this. Here I am in my far back seat where I typically go, watching our amazing music department and our talented students showcase their abilities when Devani Gibson, one of our seniors, hi Devani, was standing in front of the audience and belts out The Climb by Miley Cyrus. At that moment, I looked over at Mr. Shea and said, I got my speech. Watching Devani and listening to the chorus of this song made me think of you, the seniors, and the journey you have taken to be here tonight. Now I'm gonna share, not sing, a little bit of this song with you. I want you to take a second and think about how you would interpret these lyrics. And I'm gonna use the word ain't a couple times, I apologize. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there, ain't about what's waiting on the other side, it's the climb. And I know you're singing it, so if you don't mind bad singing, it's the climb, sorry. Your educational career has been a mountain to climb to reach this summit. All the trials and tribulations, lessons learned, obstacles faced, moments of success and failure, all led to defining who you are at this moment. VCSD and the lessons taught to you have helped create your foundation, and we here at Voorheesville cannot wait to see what you build from it. From the educator's perspective, each class has a profound impact on us. Your success is our success. Each class that has gone by, each Voorheesville, and each commencement ceremony adds to our culture and the fabric of who we are. Your names tonight will add to that, and you will forever be a part of our foundation. When you started your journey in education, one of the first stories you may have read was The Little Engine That Could by Waddy Piper. Now that you built your foundation of learning and understanding, I'd like to revisit this story one more time with you before getting to the best part of tonight, which is you getting your diplomas. I'm sure that you all remember that little blue engine that pushed themselves up to climb up that mountain by saying, I think I can, I think I can, I think I can. And I'm sure you remember the lesson that you'll take with you. Believe in yourself. This is the first step to accomplish great things in your life and in others. But there are a few other lessons that I want to remind you of tonight that I hope you bring with you as you leave. As a refresher, I'm going to give you the Cliff Note version. There was a train engine that was on the way to a village carrying toys and food for the children there, but the train stopped and could not move any further. The toys on the train tried to help, but they couldn't, so the train sat. While the train sat, two trains came by, both able to help the idle train up the mountain, but both had reasons and justification to say no, and then went on their way. The train, toys, and food sat. It wasn't until a little engine that has never climbed over the mountain or even tried to move something so large decided that it was the right thing to do when they were asked. Now, you may be thinking the lessons I'm going to share with you or that your superintendent has officially lost his mind talking about a children's book at graduation. Both could probably be true. But there are four lessons from this story I want to leave you with. But before getting them, I have to highlight the idea of cultural relativism. The world is full of people with different ideas about what is right and what is wrong. And what culture they grew up in changes how they think about things. In other words, they think like those around them, and as such, their values may be different from yours. The trains each believed they were doing the right thing based on their own values. In this instance, their values and cultures revolved around the type of work they did. Their justification of right or wrong doesn't make them good or bad. In life, it'll be important for you to realize that not every person or action is inherently good or bad. Understanding perspective will help you better work with others and impact the world around you. Despite that each train felt they were doing right, they may have been doing something wrong. And this is where it gets very confusing. Sometimes you feel you're doing the right thing, you can still be doing the wrong thing. Throughout your life, you'll make choices, some right, some wrong. When making those choices, step back. Look at perspectives. By doing so, you'll most likely always do the right thing. And that brings me to lesson number one. Pretty simple, do the right thing. Lesson two, in life, ask for what you need. Don't be afraid of the outcome. Don't choose to sit idle or have your pride get in your way. And if you do ask for support or you're told no, don't get discouraged. Continue to try and ask. Lesson number three, in life, help may come in a different package than you thought. Things may not always be as you anticipated. Understanding this can enrich your life and open doors that you never knew were there. And lastly, when asked for help or given the opportunity to do so, give it your all. You'll be amazed when you believe you can. Class of 2022, your past has been set, but your future is open. Let your actions define you. Let your name always demand the admiration that you receive here tonight. And always remember the name of your second home and the honor of the purple and gold. Congratulations.
Good evening. I'm Courtney White, and I'm honored to be introducing our graduation speaker tonight, Dr. Mary Teresa Morgan. Most students who have graduated from Voorheesville know Dr. Morgan. She taught us music and chorus at Voorheesville for 27 years while achieving her doctorate. She retired in 2019, but thankfully she taught us music from kindergarten to fifth grade and had our entire fifth grade class in our fifth grade chorus. Dr. Morgan's love of music has inspired many students to pursue music outside of school, myself included, as I took piano lessons with her from third grade until the pandemic. Her devotion to teaching and enriching our lives with music is one of the many reasons we've asked her to be here today. She's one of those teachers who has impacted our lives for good. I'm very excited to introduce you to our 2022 graduation speaker, Dr. Mary Teresa Morgan.
Good evening, everyone. Members of the Board of Education, Mr. McCree, members of the administrative team, faculty and staff, family and friends of the graduates, and most especially, graduates of the class of 2022. I cannot begin to tell you what an honor it is for me to be here and to have been asked to speak to you this evening. It is so incredibly nice to be remembered, and it is such a thrill to see all of you again. I'm trying to see all the way in the back, too. It's so good to see you again, everyone. I would like to extend a special hello to the members of your class who were not with you during your elementary school years. It is very nice to have the opportunity to meet you this evening, and it is an honor to be with you as well on this very special evening in your life. I have many, many happy memories of your class, beginning with your first days as kindergartners. My memories include your kindergarten and fifth grade graduations, your fourth grade New York State Day performance, and your wonderful fifth grade drama club production of Beauty and the Beast. I also, very especially, have vivid memories of your winter and spring concerts and our chorus rehearsals, in which we were rather tightly packed into Mrs. Beauregard's room. Do you remember that? Yes. We fit everybody in. I'm not sure how we did it, but we did. I most especially remember conducting your graduation song, which has already been mentioned this evening, For Good, from the musical Wicked. As was previously mentioned, many of you had tears in your eyes that day as you performed that song, and I did too. It was, and I know Mrs. Beauregard certainly did. It was very hard to say goodbye. 7 years have passed since your fifth grade graduation day. You are now about to leave behind a 13-year chapter of your lives and embark on your lifelong journey. You are leaving a school and a community that I treasured for 27 years, a school that has always been, in my experience, supportive and proud of its members. So before you leave this building this evening, I would like to share just a few simple thoughts with you. I begin with my favorite saying. In the first act of Shakespeare's Hamlet, Polonius says to his son Laertes, "This above all, to thine own self be true." As of January 2022, it is estimated that there are 7.9 billion people in the world, each of us unique, endowed with our own special gifts and traits. Embrace the life and the path that is set before you. Follow your dreams, believe in yourself and your abilities. And when things don't go exactly as you may have planned, learn to go with the flow of life. Many years ago, the special area teachers at the elementary school were presented with a collection of school spirit posters. Each poster depicted elementary school children exemplifying various words. One poster, for example, was entitled Friendship, another Patience. After a few years, the posters were taken down, but I chose to keep one up on the wall of my music room right through my last day of teaching in June of 2019. That poster, Lelena, was entitled Perseverance, which you also mentioned. I am a big fan of the word perseverance, always have been. I believed at the time when I left it there that the poster might help my students as they struggled to learn to play the recorder or the various band instruments. I thought of that poster, though, while writing the speech, because, as has been mentioned tonight, you, my friends, have truly persevered. The COVID-19 pandemic disrupted your high school years, but you rose to the challenge and are sitting here on this stage tonight. You persevered through the challenges of online learning, athletic games that were never played, a musical that was canceled the week of the performance. I was coming. I was so looking forward to that musical. Concerts that were never held, and countless others' challenges and disappointments. You persevered through it all, and all of us, your immediate family, as well as your school family, are very proud of you. And I think they deserve a very big round of applause. Another one of my favorite sayings is something that has been referred to simply as the golden rule. It's the idea that we should treat others as we like to be treated. I have learned to always try to remember that one never knows where another person has walked or is walking. In other words, it's best as you go through life, my friends, to try to be patient, kind, and merciful with those around you, for you never know where their life has taken them or what burdens they may have to bear. When you were with me at the elementary school for those 6 years, I often reminded you that I wanted my music room to be a kind and loving classroom, that we needed to be kind and to be patient with each other. It remains true that a smile or a kind or encouraging word does go a long way and can often be what brightens another's day. Also, as you go through life, be humble yet confident. Confidence in yourself is so important, but at the same time, humility is a very respected trait. Author C.S. Lewis, of whose writings I am quite fond, once stated, "True humility is not thinking less of yourself, it is thinking of yourself less." Another thought, one near and dear to my heart, embrace the idea of being a lifelong learner. The more you expose yourselves to different areas of study, the more interesting life becomes. And along these lines, travel whenever possible. There's so much to see. Every time I've had the opportunity to speak in Voorheesville, over the course of the past 12 years, I have mentioned my friend, Lydia C. Tobler. Lydia Crounce Tobler was a 30-year member of the district's music department and the wonderful educator after whom this beautiful performing arts center is named. She was a phenomenal music teacher, the chairman of our arts department, and a truly devoted member of our district staff. Lydia and I hope some of you in the audience remember Lydia Tobler. Lydia and I shared a special friendship for 18 years, and there has not been one day since her passing in 2010 that I have not thought of her and missed her. Lydia and I shared a love of learning, and she would often repeat to me what seemed to be her favorite saying, which I would now like to pass on to you. It was simply, body, mind, spirit. Body, mind, spirit. Lydia advocated taking time each day for exercise, reading or other mind-developing pursuits, and for nourishing one's soul. Just prior to her passing, she made me promise that I would take the time each and every day to quietly acknowledge something for which I was grateful. I can't help but believe that because of the busy, full lives we all seem to lead, we are often less than mindful of our daily blessings. I encourage you, my friends, in this graduating class, to never take anything for granted. Your health, your family, your friends, your interests, your talents, your accomplishments, your future, and all of the wonderful moments that lie ahead of you. Each day truly is a blessing. Once again, I must tell you what an honor it has been for me to speak to you this evening and to share this wonderful lifetime event with you. Most sincerely, your kindness to me and remembering me 3 years after my retirement is something that I will never forget. I leave you now with two final quotes that I love. The first reads, "Life begins at the end of your comfort zone." The second, yesterday is gone. Tomorrow has not yet come. We have only today. Let us begin. May God bless you all as you exit your comfort zone and begin an exciting new chapter of your lives. Go forth with faith in your abilities, pride in whom you are, and with excitement about who you will become. And go forth, my friends, knowing that your elementary school music teacher was truly humbled by your invitation to speak tonight, and that I will always cherish my memories of the class of 2022. Once again, God bless you and thank you.
At this time, I'd like to present the class of 2022. We're going to begin the distribution of diplomas. Board President Cindy Monahan will be handing out diplomas to our graduates, assisted by Joe Sapienza. Victoria Philomena Yakabuchi. Anna Hampston. Andrew V. Feck. Ryan Thomas McMillan. Courtney Morgan White. Rachel Grace Paul. Daniel Christopher Schillinglaw. Abigail Sidoti. Charlie G. Beauregard. Connor J. Smith. Samantha Lee Olson. Devani Janae Gibson. Aiden Timothy Strauss. Emma Jean Farrell. Gabrielle Rose Rychek. Jada Akers. Jack Harrison Behringer. Giovanni Beneduzzi Batoki. Sonia A. Banger. Allison T. Brown. Sean Patrick Bruno Jr. Carly Faith Burke. Carly May Burke. Adriana Flora Casola. Taylor Elizabeth Chura. Richard Joseph Clark. Noah Gabriel Clow. Ryan B. Conley. Arthur Dandolo. Dominic J. Dana. Luke J. Day. Lilith Grace DeFreeze Rundo. Stephen D. Dommermuth. Utah M. Duffy. Morgan Kathleen Eidelman. Philip Charles Gannon. Michael J. Gardner. Haley May Gleesman. Trevor Michael Gilmet. William Carter Hillman. Phoenix Galen Homer. Ryan M. Horn. Kaylin P. Johnson. Bryce J. Jones. Jack J. Kane. Jack Michael Keith. Jackson A. Keller. Ella Kelly. Axel Kotakowski. Cameron P. Kranz. Alexandra J. Krasansky. Kalen Jacob Lamberton Dunham. Aiden Michael Lawson. Jaden Lombardi. Bridget Lorraine Longdon. Jane Elizabeth Longdon. Joseph R. Lucas. Quinn M. Lucas. Damon Mazurek. Tegan Marie McGinn. Layla Marie McKinley. Haya J. Mundanero. Lillianne Rose Morrison. Caitlin Marie Odorizzi. Megan Odorizzi. Carolyn J. Apoka. Martin F. Apoka. Anthony Papa. Christopher C. Puccini. Gianna M. Pigeon. Jack T. Popo. Michael E. Raganese. Nicholas J. Riley. Renata M. Reynolds. Alexis Marie Catherine Rodriguez. Julia Rogers. Abigail K. Rothwine. Madeline Daly Rusin. Hannah Susan Rudolph. John Vincent Saya. Jacob Saracetti. Logan E. Service. Charles Henry Spolin. Eileen Sun. Isabella L. Thayer. Joseph Graham Tomlin. Leo Wilridge. Fiona Grace Wickstrom. Zachary Woodruff. And we have two students who could not make it here this evening. Those two students are Alex James Brecht. and Jack William Woods. And now, accepting the applause for the class of 2022, our valedictorian, Lelena Elizabeth Beauregard. Members of the class of 2022, please stand. According to the regulations of the Department of Education in the state of New York, and by the power and authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and the Superintendent of Schools of the Voorheesville Central School District, I now declare that all of you standing before me today are graduates of Clayton A. Bouton High School with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto apprehending. Graduates, please remove your tassels from your left to your right, or your right to your left, sorry. Congratulations, you are now officially Clayton A. Bouton High School graduates. The audience to remain seated, or please be seated, while our staff, followed by our graduates, leave the pack. Thank you all for attending tonight's commencement ceremony. We invite you all to attend the post-graduation reception that will be held in the main gym. We wish our graduates the very best in their future endeavors.